have no idea what I'm doing. Like, hey, this is what I do. Like, yeah. I write music, this is what I do. And then be like, well, this is why I do it. And then get into like, well, how you do it. So, for those of you that don't know, I write a lot of music. It's probably the understatement of the week, along with many other things. In those couple of years that I've spent writing, I've learned a lot about myself. I've learned a lot about what I really want out of music. And through a lot of music that I've learned from, I've learned really what makes me tick. In a lot of ways, because for me music is entirely central to pretty much my entire daily life, to the point where I feel that I wake up most days and once I get past those weird 7 a.m. thoughts, my thoughts are immediately drifting to, okay, what can I do with music today? How can I get better at something? And, you know, maybe somewhere down the line I might think about school, but I might be showing my hand on my priorities a little bit too quickly, but where I'm at with it, I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm generally pretty straightforward about that sort of thing. And I've watched a lot of different vlogs over the past few weeks, and I've just been thinking to myself, I really wanna be on that level to share with people, but what is it that I can share? And every conversation I've had with anybody, it's come back to, well, why don't you do something with your music? And I keep thinking about it. And to me, the writing process is the most important catharsis that I have. I mean, there's not many things in my life as a 21-year-old college student that I have control over, really. And so I feel that it's why I'm so nitpicky. It's why I get the most out of it relative to other things like school at this point. And I think there's something to be shared there, because my writing style is not based on music theory. Really, I'm learning concepts as I go along, but it's all in here. It's not really coming from an exercise or something to that effect that turns into music. Especially in the melodic aspects, I even took music theory and I still don't know key signatures and all those basic things that you music majors probably do. I don't know a whole lot, really. That's why I'm here. That's why I'm learning. And when I say here, I mean here talking to you, not here at college. Because obviously, I'm not a music major. I'm a marketing major. I'm not here to learn about how to write music, because I got to a certain point and I realized that I just don't want anybody else telling me what to do when it comes to that. Because I have to submit myself to a lot of people for a lot of different things, and it's just not something I want to do. I don't want to be told how to express myself. And if you need someone to help you, that's fine. Like, that's probably part of why I wanted to do this, is if I can do nothing else but inspire someone, just one or two or three people that really want to write music but just think it's just such a daunting thing. It's not. I mean, yeah, it takes a long time, and it's taken me a long time to get to where I want to be with music, to get what's in here or what's in here onto that guitar over there or this little practice pad set up behind here. But it was just a matter of work. I mean, yes. Is talent a thing? Yes and no. Like, it's the spark that gets you to work hard if you really want it. But what separates people like me from people that are wanting to write music is just a matter of time and commitment, which is a scary word to most people my age, but it's something I'm really passionate about, and these thoughts are just flowing as freely as I could think of. And in a similar way, I want the presentation of what I'm sharing with you to be as stream as consciousness based as possible, because that is entirely how things come to me. I will be working on 4 or 5 different songs at a time and just putting little bits of inspired ideas in there, and that's what becomes the song in the end. Is just really well refined, in my opinion, but very originally raw ideas that you just kind of shape as time goes on. And I think showing not only the inspiration portion that leads to the original writing, that's going to be more difficult because it's so spontaneous for me, but the more methodical refining aspect is where most of the work is. And I think it's, again, what separates me from people that love the idea of writing music, but maybe don't necessarily get around to putting in the work. Because, at least to me at this point, the most gratifying part of the process is that, like, the meat of it. Because it's not easy, and it's what separates people who want to be great from those who just love the idea. And I'm gonna probably come back to that countless times talking about this stuff, but you can love the idea of being really good at something, but as my parents have said and taught me many times over, it's about what you do after that. I think in one of Kendrick's songs he says, "A dream is only a dream if work doesn't follow it." Paraphrasing a little bit, but it's true. And look at where he is, and he's doing exactly what he wants to do. Sure, I mean, I'm not a hip-hop artist, but I am an individual, and I know what I want out of music and out of my life related to music. And I think that this is just me wanting to chronicle what will lead me to those greater things that I have in mind that I'll share with you as time goes on. So, let me know what you think. I'm open to suggestions. I was thinking I would probably use a lot of screen cap. Like I said, capturing the spontaneous riff writing is difficult, but I'll find a way to do it. And if there's more maybe daily vlog stuff that I could do, I mean by daily, I mean like daily life, like the boring parts of my life that for some odd reason are really interesting and vlogs to me and everyone else that watch them on YouTube. But like I said, just let me know what you think, suggestions, ideas, whatever, I'm open to it. I'll try not to edit the crap out of this video, but I don't want people thinking that I stutter normally when I talk, because I don't. I'm just not really used to talking to a camera. Anyway, that's it for now, so talk to you soon.